Verification of a system is about checking that a model of a system satisfies a property. And the property is a correctness property, a desirable property. Now, when I started working on model checking, the dominant approach on verification was axiomatic verification. So axiomatic verification, roughly speaking, is about reasoning, okay, you produce a proof that the model of the system satisfies the property by reasoning on the structure of the description of the system. And of course, there are well-known limitations of non-decidability. So you can formalize proof rules, give proof rules, but achieving the proof depends on how much smart, intelligent is the guy who carries out the proof. So my idea was that we should have verification techniques that are automated. And to make verification automated, of course, you should get rid of the limitation of undecidability. So I decided to restrict to finite state systems. And in fact, the examples of protocols was really motivating because these are hard to verify and still finite state. I mean, you can find a reasonably good finite state systems. So what's the big difference between model checking and the other techniques, the previous techniques, the axiomatic techniques, is that you extract a model of the system and then you evaluate, in order to check the property, you evaluate the property on the model. And this, okay, now I'll skip technicalities. This is like computing a fixed point of some monotonic function. And of course, if the model of the system is finite, the computation will converge, and then you have a proof method. So this method differs drastically from axiomatic verification because it's global. It can be applied, so you ignore about the structure of the description, you generate a model, you flatten the system. So you should know the semantics, okay, semantic model of the system, and then you perform some evaluation and okay, if the model is not complex enough, then you... And also this method works for non-terminating systems, because you probably know that for non-terminating systems, particular parallel systems, axiomatic techniques were not very easy to apply. So this is quite general, and this is applicable to non-terminating systems, which are, in my opinion, the hardest system to verify. Okay, and this so model checking has initially been applied to hardware systems because for obvious reason it's finite state. And then to software. So the application software is much harder because the hard problem here is how to find a model of a software. And so some abstract model of software. In order to do that, you should, so if you have a program written in some programming language, say Java or C, the model is generated by taking into account the operational semantics of the language. And this, of course, involves a lot of technical issues. In particular, if you you should decide perhaps the semantics of existing programming languages is not very rigorously defined.
Yes.
So you have to deal with that also, okay? After I had a student working on the semantics of Java, real-time of Java. And then you see that Java, okay, you have a lot of issues, semantic issues, okay, that are left open. And this should be decided, okay, when you do this exercise. So today, model checking of software is very important for big companies. But for this, you need some technology that is heavy. I mean, you need the compilers to models, abstraction techniques. It's fairly complicated technology. And